What is up, friends? I'm joining you after a chill, laid-back midday class. I wanted to come on and talk to you a little bit about music because I posted some songs this morning on my stories that I usually post music before classes, like my hype music, my reggaeton, my timba, my bachata, Afro house, lo que sea, whatever it is that I'm using to kind of get fired up to like have the energy to hit the screen. But the music we use in class is a full-on wide variety. And I wanted to just talk about my music selection process because for me, music plays a lot of different really important roles in the workouts that I'm trying to deliver, the movement sessions I'm trying to deliver for people. Number one, just moving to music for me is fundamentally functional human movement. We hear this term in fitness a lot, like functional movement is movement that relates more to like practical movement for the human animal, like things we need to be able to do. But moving to music is also fundamentally human. And we have so much weird dance phobia in our culture, speaking just in the West, mostly because we're so self-conscious and self-critical and we think of dance as performative as opposed to just expressive and explorative, which is totally toxic. Just putting that out there. But it's why people are like, I've got two left feet or I have no rhythm. It's like, that's not true. You're so super self-conscious. You're distorting your ability to let that music in. And when you do that, you're actually denying yourself like a whole nutrient food group because your tissue and your brain loves sound and it experiences sound on a tactile, like nervous system, sensory experiential level. Which you know, if for example, you've listened, like some people are more permeable to music than I am. I'm hypersensitive to music. Like I cannot listen to music when I'm gonna eat because it will just shut off my hunger. You've listened to music that is of a melancholy nature, like a minor key nature, or you've listened to hype, like energizing music, and you can feel it affects your mood and your whole system differently. And that's really, this is nothing that hasn't also been tested. Like people with several different types of neurological disorders even respond to music because of the way it affects your brain. And then there's all the like baby Beethoven shit, right? Like they're trying to like stimulate the brain. That's no fun, but I'm glad people are thinking about it. So music for me and moving to music is part of what makes my exercise system or the exercise system that I'm trying to share with people functional. It's as functional as a squat pattern to do movement to music, not with music on, okay? Not with the distraction factor, but doing the movement in a way that is infused by and influenced and informed by the sound that's in your space. And my goal in my classes, although you guys can tell, I talk and I love to educate people about the anatomy and the objectives that we're working on and obviously how to do the movements safely and purposefully for maximum effect in their body physically. But my goal is that ultimately the music is foregrounded and they stop listening to me or I start talking less because we've been doing the same workout for a few weeks. And then the music can be more front and center and can really become a more musical experience without it having any performative pressure of dance. One of the nice things about working in Zoom and with people in their homes is that they probably aren't using a mirror and they're not looking at other people. And I try to get them to not even watch me once we've done a few reps of something so that they really are feeling the music and hopefully feeling the movements and that beautiful sync up with their body. The other thing about music that I think is really valuable, and it's on the same line, right? It's that it's functional, it's human, it's functional, it's important. It's important to expose your body to different flavors of music the same way you're going to get different food groups in your palate, nutrient-wise. And that is also why my classes usually span a wide variety of sound flavors as well, from stuff that's a little bit more percussive, everything from like classical, hip-hop classical, and more of the percussive stuff that I like for my hype music in like strengthening portions of the class, stuff that has a little bit of like intensity, a lot of instrumental hip-hop and things like that, but also more of the fluid, flowy, yin-style sounds, like some of the stuff I posted today. And those different sounds are speaking to different tissue needs in your body. I need to be able to create power. I need to be able to create tension and tensegrity is the term, right? I need to be able to create impact against my environment, push into the floor, support my feet, drive through my muscles, pull up on my spine, right? I need to be able to create those forces in all, for all kinds of reasons in life. And there's plenty of other sports that dominate that type of physical training. But we also want, and one of the ways Essentrics shines is as a mobility and conditioning program that is trying to get our tissue to move more softly, right? To release tension in our body, to release unproductive tension, like tension we hold in our shoulders. Just one quick example, because that's what I have on the screen, but we hold tension and grip in our body in all kinds of ways. We want to release unproductive tension so that we can create purposeful tension that I was just talking about. It happens in dance all the time. Someone's got super tight shoulders, so you can't feel their core because you can't get through their shoulders to where it connects. Just silly example for hopefully people understand that. But that's one example. But we have unpurposeful tension that gets in the way of performance tension all the time. But we also just want to release and do some conditioning work for our connective tissue that needs fluid, soft movement. Your fascia, we have connective tissue throughout our body. That's a whole like TED talk, right? Look up fascia, connective tissue, the importance of it for your health and longevity in whatever you do with your body. A lot of times people think about mobility, they're thinking about joint health and the joint-based connective tissue. And that's fabulous and super important. And Essentrics does a lot of work for strengthening the muscles around your joints and preserving and actually just moving your joints non-loaded, getting them in their full range of motion that you have access to today is a beautiful way to preserve your joint health. Restore, preserve your joint health. Definitely, like arthritic issues, it's very much just joint driven. But we also have our fascial connective tissue, which is this like mesh. I mean, there's all kinds of ways people describe it. It's like cellophane sheets, right? Or a thicker or thinner density in the body, of having a stretchy, elastic, tactile nature, of being like a mesh system that supports and encases every fiber of every muscle, and as well as on a larger scale, encasing the muscles themselves and our internal organs. We are just full of this stuff, and it's a big part of what gives our body a coherent experience. Neurologically, because a lot of our nervous system runs through our connective tissue like a superhighway. And also for like the way our muscles interact, right? We are not atomized pieces of like muscle, limb, bone, joint. We work as a system, at least when we're working optimally. And for example, when we don't have unproductive tension that's working as an impasse to let our body move athletically and optimally. And Essentrics is genius at getting into the type of movement that is best nurturing of this connective tissue. This gliding, hydrating, softening, releasing connective tissue that also then we condition it in those circumstances, but it has different qualities of like creating that tension, for example, that tensegrity, that purposeful, stabilizing, body coherent tension. But it needs to be released. Just like a muscle needs to stretch so that it can maximally contract, our connective tissue has to be able to get soft and loose and glide and be hydrated and elastic so that it can do its supportive job. And there's not that many workouts that, and including mobility programs, you see a lot of like hard style mobility. There are not as many workouts that do that as well as Essentrics. And I, you know, almost 10 minutes in, I just want to say, for me, in addition to the movements in Essentrics, one of the things that's bringing that to life is the music and is moving to softer, bassy. Like, it's not pop music, it's not empty. It's bassy, muscular music that also has a melodic flow that helps us get into that melodic movement. I'm going to cut this off before Instagram would cut me off, and hopefully this is interesting to some of you. If you haven't tried class, join. If you'd like a playlist to see it, whether you have or not been to class, ask. If you've been to class and you want some music from me, ask. It makes me so happy. Move to music, people. It is fundamentally human. Mwah.